Sweet.
The Rand Band is sponsors over 250 radios each year through the PRCA, the NIRA, the National High School Radio Association, as well as the National Little Bridges Association, and many others. Rand Rodeo has a 20-year history of sponsoring rodeos in both the U.S. and Canada.
Can I learn more from him?
As a member of NIRA, FCA affiliates,
offers
the third pricing at 1% of all factory invoice when purchasing, select Chrysler, Jeep,
but not nothing.
Yeah, there you go.
For information, please contact Emily at the RAM office at 641-684-6000. Dick's the flag of Cactus Ropes. Cactus Ropes, founded in 1991, manufactures ropes that are the most durable and consistent products available. They can be found at local retailers, or you can contact them at www.cactusropes.com. Give them a call at 1-800 SPIDWIND. Cactus Ropes.
I wasn't sure I should run it.
Also sponsoring the NIRA is Cactus Saddle. At Cactus Saddle, values and ethics are more than words, they are business philosophies. Cactus Saddle offers a full line of saddles, strap bits designed and manufactured by their handcrafts. Visit them at www.cactussaddle.com. We also have sponsoring Resist All Hats. They fly behind Resist All Hats, which is the official hat maker for college rodeo. They are the largest manufacturer in the world, and they produce the highest quality product through all phases of production. Resist All Hats. Dick's flag of Visit Casper. Casper, Wyoming. Wyoming's adventure capital. With one foot in the past and the eye toward the future, Casper is a year-round destination that offers the very best in historical, recreational, cultural, and entertainment experiences. Casper, the proud home of the college national finals to be held this year, June 11th through the 17th of 2023. Our final sponsor, we will fly the flag of Big Iron. Big Iron Nine Lashers, brought to you by Luke Campbell. Sponsors locally along with Synapse. So we thank Big Iron and Synapse for their sponsorship as we serve the flags of those two corporations. So a huge thank you once again to all of our national corporate sponsors. With the National Intercollegiate Radio Association, we will spend some time going through our other sponsors here tonight, local sponsors, and we are going to have our business as well. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it is tradition in the sport of rodeo before we do anything that we pause and then we give thanks to our creator before saluting the American flag. So at this time, I'd like to ask that you stand and remove your cover. Join my first to stand on the prayer to be followed by the playing of our special hymn. Gracious Heavenly Father, we pause from our routine, and we take a moment for prayers and thanksgiving. Our lives are deeply enriched by the friendships and the bonds that we have formed, and we are thankful for the opportunity to come together with this rodeo family. Please help all those involved here tonight, including both our student and our animal athletes, to perform to the best of their abilities. And when we arrive at the end of this day, may we be reminded that to you is all the praise and glory. We offer prayers of thanksgiving for this country that we live in, and we ask that you watch over, guide, and bless the men and women of our armed forces, both at home and abroad, as they stand guard over the freedoms that allow us to do the things that we love to do. We ask that you hear these prayers along with those prayers held deep in our hearts and in the hearts of your faithful that are all offered in the name of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. For joining us for a salute to our flag, for the pause in prayer. Today I want to welcome you to Torrington, Wyoming, on behalf of Whit Peterson, the head of Eastern Wyoming College, along with Dr. Jeffrey Hart, president of Eastern Wyoming College. Tom Anderson,
well, welcome.
We are so glad to have you in Goshen County and in Torrington with us.
Welcome to the 2023 Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Rodeo. We're glad you're with us tonight. If you can't be in person, this is a good place to watch it. We had some slack this afternoon with the goat tying. We have a 6-7 and a 6-8 leading it. We're going to get right off into the rodeo action here. Start out with Claire Nurr from the University of Wyoming, followed by Carissa Rahill and Lena Schiller. This is Claire Neer, University of Wyoming. Got that one tied up. Be a 13-2 for Claire. Next goat tire is Carissa Rahill right here from Eastern Wyoming College. Carissa is reigning Central Rocky Mountain Region champion goat tire and all-around cowgirl. Dang good run right there. I think we had a little bad luck with the horse crossing the rope. Would have been a 7-2, but because of that, we're adding 10 to 17-2. Next will be Lena Schiller from Northeastern Junior College. This is Lena Schiller from NJC.
Our goat tying sponsor.
A little trouble with the tie right there. Be a 13-5 for Lena. Ellie Redinger from Casper College will be next. I'd like to make a shout out to Newman Realty. They have been a sponsor of this rodeo for as long as I can remember, and we really appreciate that. Blair Newman and the gang down there at Newman Realty, specializing in farms, ranches, residential, and recreational properties. Newman Realty, Torrington, Wyoming. Here is Ellie Redinger. And that'll be in no time. Looked like the goat got up. We'll go again here with another Lancer, Brinley Logan. Following her will be McKenna Fisher. Good start right there, a little tough finish.
That is official on Brinley Logan, 9-2.
9.2 for Brinley.
Nicely
done. McKenna Fisher from Chadron State College is next. Will be followed by Sadie Johnson, Kelsey Lindsgraf, and Riker Goodman will finish the go time tonight. Got one wrapped up. Oh, it looked like the goat kicked free. It'll be in no time for McKenna. Colorado State University cowgirl Sadie Johnson is next, followed by Kelsey Lindsgraf, Riker Goodman. Then we'll get into some bareback riding. Once again, thanks for joining us tonight. We got a good crowd here at the Lancer Rodeo. Great weekend in March to watch a rodeo. .4 for Sadie. Kelsey Lindsgraf, University of Wyoming, will be your next goat tire, followed by Riker Goodman. Oh, Kelsey put a nice run together right there.
That'll shake up the leaderboard. Let's make it official before I get it to you. How about a 7.5
for Kelsey Lindsgraf. That will put her in the third spot. Good position to make short round. Next goat tire, Zeta Eastern Wyoming College team member Riker Goodman. Had a little tumble there, but finished strong. 9.9 for Riker. That'll finish up the go time for tonight. We're looking at Kelsey Lindsgraf's a 7.5 winning the performance. We still got that 6.7 by Faith Hoffman sitting first and 6.8 by Hayden Thompson sitting second. It's looking like right now a long 7 is going to be in that top 10. We'll be right back with some bareback riding.
Getting ready for our first bareback riding action here at Lancer Rodeo 2023. Got 7 bareback riders for you here tonight. Looks like we're going to start off at shoot 3. That's the 21st Century Equipment shoot. Thanks for the sponsor and supporting Lancer Rodeo. Donnie Prophet, University of Wyoming Cowboy, first man to go. And a great ride started here for our first ride tonight. We'll see what happens when the scores come in. Great ride by Donnie Prophet, University of Wyoming Cowboy. But a 77-point ride for Donnie Prophet, the University of Wyoming Cowboy. Number 3 in the region. Good way to start it off tonight. Go to Cooper Filipek. Of Gillette College. He's going to be in shoot number 2. Our RNC Welding Fabrication Trucking and Crane Shoot. Gillette College Cowboys set to go. Big thanks to our Outgate sponsor, TDS Collection. All your trash needs in Torrington, Wyoming, and Goshen County. And a huge thanks to our ambulance sponsor as well, the Goshen County Wellness Clinic. And Cooper Filipek looks to get set. Nod his head in the RNC Welding Fabrication Trucking and Crane Shoot. Number 2. Here we go. A little bit of horse troubles getting out so far. And he'll try to spur the bay Southwick horse. And he makes it to the buzzer. Scores coming in for Cooper Filipek.
safely to the ground. I want to thank our pickup men, Greg Huxtable, along with Paul Redeke. The score on Philip at 73 points.
So 73 for Cooper Filipek. I moved to second place in our bareback riding. Two up, two down. Cinch Kiger, Shadron State College. We'll be next to go. Cinch Kiger will be in shoot number one, left side of your screen. Stainless and blue ink shoot. A little bit trouble getting our bareback horse out here. Sorry. Midwest AgriPro pickup men trying to work to get him out. Still working to get our horse out of the chute. Into that TDS out gate. Thanks to Brown Company, Torrington, Wyoming, for your support of Lancer Rodeo. And here we go. Our Midwest AgriPro pickup men run him through the TDS out gate. And here we go, we're back on track. Shoot number one, Cinch Rider. Our second spring rodeo of the 2023 season for Central Rocky Mountain region. And the Shadron State College Cowboy will be next to go. We're 2 for 2 on the Southwick horses so far tonight. Got a 77 by Donnie Prophet. 73 by Cooper Filipek.
All right. Glenn Southwick down here directing traffic. He knows the horses like the back of his hand. Again, we appreciate you giving all of the athletes here tested your help. You can do so as soon as that shoot date cracks.
Great crowd accumulating here in Torrington, Wyoming. Always is in our second event so far. Hope we can fill the stands tonight. And here's Cinch Kiger. And we're going to get another one covered. That's 3 for 3 in the bareback riding. There's a Shadron State Cowboy. Looks to dismount this white horse. Scores coming in from our judges.
When he is safely on the ground, we'll let him know that the score moves him to a tie for number 2. About 73 points.
73 for Cinch Kiger. He'll go to a split for second. And that's 3 for 3 tonight. That's always good to watch. We're going to go to Bryce Patterson, the number 2 man in the region. Bryce Patterson coming out of the Dinklage Feed Yard shoot. number 4. Farthest left on your screens. And the number 2 man in the region gets set to go. 3 good rides so far, but this bareback is still wide open. This is Bryce Patterson going to work. And another good bareback ride for the University of Wyoming Cowboy. Points for Bryce Patterson. He will go to number 1 in the round. Go to shoot number 5. Tanner Drewke, LCCC. Be your next cowboy to go. Get a quick horse switch for our pickup man. Shoot number 5. See a mistake on our part. It's going to be Drake Adminson coming out of the Goshen Vet. Shoot number 5. See if the UW Cowboy can join his teammates on top of the leaderboard. And he'll have his horse go down. Still going to stick with him. Most likely going to be a reride option here for Drake Adminson. Scores coming in. And Drake Adminson will take a re-ride. He'll get on his other bareback horse during the bronc riding, at the end of the bronc riding. Let's go to shoot number 6. Miles Carlson, number 1 man in the region. Casper College Thunderbird. This will be our last bareback rider tonight. Miles Carlson trying to make it a good finish. I'm in trouble getting this horse going. He'll cover him. And that's a perfect 6 for 6 by our Cowboys here tonight in our first section of bareback riding. Great riding by our Cowboys. Scores coming in. And it'll be a 77 for Miles Carlson. So after 6 bareback riders, anybody's game. Bryce Patterson with a 78 leads the way. Donnie Profit and Miles Carlson both have a 77. And Cooper Filipek and Cinch Kiger tied at the bottom with a 73. 6 rides, good bareback riding, some steer wrestling coming up. Thank you to Titan Machinery for presenting our bareback riding.
So.
I'll do bull riding.
Your wrestlers,
you'll be followed by the team roping. Then we'll come right back down here for the bronc riding. Now, Drake Adamson will take that re-ride. We will run him for putting him in with the bronc riders. Back at you here, getting ready to steer wrestle. Once again, Drake Adamson, you know, the re-ride and the bareback riding, they will bring him back probably right there at the beginning of the bronc saddle bronc riding, sorry. We'll start off the steer wrestling with Jet Van Zwiezen, Bernard Girard, Wyatt Stevens, Parker Johnston, Rio Nutter, Thane Kimbrough, Donald Quick, and finish it off with Jacob Wang. Steer wrestling is brought to you by 20 Mile Mine out of Oak Creek, Colorado. I'd like to bring you some sponsors tonight as well. We would like to thank the Fizzbomb Barrel Race Classic out of Gillette, Wyoming. This is a long-standing event that's been around for some time now. They paid out over $420,000 last year, and they're also adding breakaway and tie-down futurity and open in the fall of 23. September 6th through the 10th, Fizzbomb Classic, brought to you by the Thar Ranch Productions. Here he goes, Jet Van Zwiezen, had a little luck there. Oh, had to ride right by. We'll go with Bernard Girard next out of Laramie County Community College. Bernard backing in the box. Oh, has a steer stead up just a little bit. Tough catch. No time for Bernard. We will go with Wyatt Lee Stevens out of Central Wyoming College, followed by Parker Johnston and Rio Nutter. Sure appreciate Diamond Nine Fencing out of Minotaur, Nebraska. They say best of luck to all the Lancer Rodeo contestants. Diamond Nine Fencing. We got Wyatt Stevens backing in the box. We would like to thank Matt Idler Photography. He has provided a lot of great action shots to Lancer Rodeo and beyond. IdlerPhoto.com. Here we go with Matt. Sorry, Wyatt Stevens, Central Wyoming College. Great little run right there. Wow, he set the pace. 3.7 for Wyatt Stevens. Great way to start off the steer wrestling. Parker Johnston, Shatter State College, will be next, followed by Rio Nutter and Thane Kimbrough. Be Parker Johnston, Chatham State College. I'd like to thank the Red Barn Boutique, Jamie Wilkins. You can find them at www.redbarnboutique.store. Here goes Parker. Strong steer, but he got him thrown down. Parker just threw that steer in 7.5, but he did get the barrier, end up with a 17.5. Next steer wrestler, Rio Nutter from the University of Wyoming. He'll be followed by Thane Kimbrough. I'd like to thank Cool Customs, Body and Paint, Gary Hunter and the crew there. They can fix you up. Great mechanics and auto body work. Best of luck to all Lancer Rodeo contestants from Gary Hunter and the crew at Cool Customs Paint and Body. Rio Nutter lets one loose there. Strong steer. It'll be no time for Rio. Rio's having a great rodeo. I think he's leading the tie-down roping and the team roping at this point. Thane Kimbrough, Laramie County Community College, followed by Donald Quick. We'll finish up with Jacob Wang. Goes Thane Kimbrough. Good catch. Got the nose. Good throw. Nice solid run by Thane Kimbrough. A 5.9. Put him in the number two spot. Here's an EWC Lancer, Donald Quick, from out in the Craig, Colorado country. I'd like to thank our friends at Point West Community Bank. Partner with us to finance your dreams. Located in Torrington, Lingle, Pine Bluffs, and Douglas. Point West Community Bank. Oh, just missed him. Be no time for Donald. We will finish up the steer wrestling with Jacob Wang from the University of Wyoming. Jacob sitting in the back of the box. Got a good start, good catch, and a great throw. .48 for Jacob Wang. That'll put him in the number two spot. So after the first perf of steer wrestling, we got Wyatt Stevens with 3.7. Jacob Wang with a 4.8, and Thane Kimbrough rounds out the top three with a 5.9. We'll be right back with you at the team roping.
Prepared for some good team roping for you tonight. Thanks for joining us on YouTube, Facebook Live, wherever you're watching here. Kyler Clark, along with my dad, Jake Clark. Big thanks to Keith Smith and the rest of the crew up here making this all possible. Going to start the team roping tonight. Braden Fillmore, Troop Coors, Weston Mills, Braden Brost, Haley Hardeman, and Katie Kendrick as your first three teams. Some very capable teams up first here tonight. Otero Junior College and the University of Wyoming. Two freshman Cowboys out of Colorado. Big thanks to Gold Spur Productions sponsoring our team roping. Let's see what Braden Troop can do. Good start, hard running black steer. Good head catch from Braden Troop on the backside. He'll catch a leg on a strong black steer. 7-8 plus 5. Gonna be the time for Braden and Troop. We had some really, really good team roping earlier today in our Slack. Rio Nutter and Reese Rodhams set the pace as the third team out with a 6-1. We've got a 6-5, a 7-8, and a pair of eights to round out our top five. Here's Weston Mills, Braden Brost. Good turn, good heel shot, and a very solid run from the Casper College Cowboys. 5-8, that'll go to the lead for Weston and Braden. 5-8, our first sub six second run. Great run from those two. Let's go to Haley Hartman and Katie Kendrick. On deck gonna be Haley Hardeman, Katie Kendrick next to go. Rain Grant, Mason Bice, Ellie Bard, Kevy Bronco. Third out. At 5'8", the fastest run we've seen throughout the day. That's something that may stand throughout this whole rodeo. Good head catch from Haley Hardeman. We'll get a turn. Katie Kendrick on the backside. Dragon steer. This heel loop's not going to work. It'll be a no time for those two. Move us to Rain Grant, Mason Bice. Come from Laramie County Community College.
She went to the National High School Finals last summer and had a week.
Once again, big thanks to Gold Spur Productions, our event sponsor for this team roping. And thanks to Diamond Nine Fencing, strip and shoot sponsor. Yeah, this will be another no time. Move to Ellie Bard, Kevy Bronco. Thanks to Case IH Titan Machinery out of Torrington, Wyoming for supporting Lancer Rodeo. Thanks to San Pedro Mexican Restaurant, just down in Main Street in Torrington. Make sure to let everyone know, head on down there for some good Mexican food. Thanks to Pinnacle Bank, always a great sponsor of Lancer Rodeo. And a big thanks to H&R Block. And good luck to all the Lancer Rodeo contestants. Ellie Bard backing in the box, getting ready to go. Seen a penalty and then a new leader tonight in the team roping. Saw some good roping this morning. Your top three right now is Weston Mills and Braden Brost. You saw them just a couple minutes ago with a 5'8". They're winning it. Second's Rio Nutter and Reese Wadhams with that 6'1", 6'5" from Colton Storer and Rhett Witt is in third place right now. We've got a head catch, quick heel shot, not going to work. Maybe another no time. Three in a row. Some Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Cowgirls. The Mesa Crouching and Jessica Woodward. And headshot is not going to work for the Lancer Cowgirl. Oh, she's going to get it fished on, and it's going to be an illegal head loop. Going to be no time for the Lancers. Well, let's go to Stratton Corn, Quincy Reynolds. A pair of the rodeos for the lone university in our region, the University of Wyoming in Laramie, the Cowboys. It'll be the second-to-last team to go, Drinchy Drinkins and Peyton Fader. Stratton and Quincy getting set to go. Out of the barrier. Got a headshot. Quincy on the backside. He'll clean one up. And another smooth run. Should move him into the top five or so. Seven five for Stratton and Quincy. They'll move them to fourth. Good run from the Cowboys of the University of Wyoming. Gentry Jenkins, Peyton Fader. Be the last team to go in our perf. A little horse trouble in the box for Gentry. Got a quick head catch for the LCCC Cowgirl. Hilloop's going to come up empty. Another no time. So Weston Mills and Braden Brost going to be your quickest time of the perf, and they're going to be the quickest time of the rodeo so far as well with a 5-8. Go to first. They'll move the leaderboard. They go to number one. Number two is going to be Rio Nutter Reese Wadhams with a 6-1. Third is going to be Cole DeStore, Rhett Witt with a 6-5. Number four, Stratton Cord, Quincy Reynolds. We just saw them a minute ago with their 7-5. And rounding out the top five, Clay Helm of Casper, Riley Barber of Central Wyoming with a 7-8. Big thanks to Gold Spur Productions, our team roping event sponsor. We'll move on to the Saddle Bronc at the other end of the arena.
Well, welcome back. We're going to get started here with the Fred Peterson Memorial Saddle Bronc Riding. Fred, longstanding resident of Goshen County, father of the coach Whit Peterson. He had some really nice spurs made by Blake Offdahl Bits and Spurs for the champion this weekend. The first thing we're going to do is go back to that re-ride in the bareback riding, Drake Amundson from the University of Wyoming. Here goes Drake. A little stronger horse this time. He's hanging on. Oh, that's a close one. We'll have to take a look at the judges and see if he made it. He did make it. 68 points for Drake. So that will finish out our bareback riding for tonight. We'll move on to the bronc riding. You look at the left of your screen, we're going to start it. Shoot number two. Casper College Cowboy. now who?
That was a rough start on the bump. We had no score on Colton Wagner. Dropped out of the arena. Glad to see that.
That was Colton Wagner. He drew a rough one tonight. It'll be a no score for him. If you look at shoot number one, Riley Barber from Central Wyoming College will be our next Bronc Rider. Out of the stainless and blue shoot, shoot number one. There he goes. Oh, gets into the fence. Looks like he's doing all right. There'll be a no score for Riley. I'd like to thank Laramie Physicians, Women and Wellness Clinic in Laramie, Wyoming. LaramiePhysicians.com. If you'll look at shoot number four, Cody Weeks. Dinklage Feed Yard Buck and Shoot. Cody Weeks out of Sheridan College. Looks like we're trying to get him cinched up, get down on him. Nod of the head, here we go. And just off the side, about four hops. Be a no score. Next Bronc Rider is going to come out of Casper College, Quanah Glade. If you'll watch shoot number five there, Goshen Vet, Buck and Shoot. There he goes, getting tapped off. I think we're going to have a qualified ride. Hang on. Looks like he's off the fence. Looks like we're going to have a score for Quanah.
This time, the athleticism of that dismount was
They're going to give Quanah a 66 score. He will be the leader at the moment. Let's go over to shoot number 6 on your right. That is our Red Barn Boutique shoot. This will be Cyan Ahern from Casper College out of shoot 6. Here it goes, Cyan Ahern, getting one started. Wild horse. Gets him covered. Looks like we missed him out on the left side. Be a no score for Cyan. Looks like we're going to shoot 5 here after we switch our pickup man's horses. It's going to be Casey Rosenthal from Casper College. Looks like Casey's getting the cinches tight, getting ready to get on. I'd like to thank the Cobblestone Hotel and Suites, 1306 Main Street in Torrington. Great new motel there. Give them a call, 532-1033. The Cobblestone Inn and Suites. Looks like Casey's getting on, getting ready to go. Looks like got him marked out. A little duck and diving horse, but he's gassing it. Good hustle, Casey. Looks like we're going to get our second score of the night. Well, he's going to go to lead right here with 68 points. Looks like we're going back to the other side. Once we get this horse out. We're going to go with Sheridan College, Tayson Jones, and the RNC Welding Bucking Chute number 2. I'd like to thank Goshen Vet Clinic, large and small animals. Great vet clinic right here in Goshen County. I'll tell you what, most of us will probably be hungry after the rodeo. Best place to go is the Bucking Horse Grill. Comfort food with bold flavors. Monday through Saturday, 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. The Bucking House Steakhouse and Grill. Tacy's getting on his horse, getting ready to nod. have not got word on Taysom if it was a score or a grab. I'll let you know as soon as I find out. We're going to go to shoot one with Seth Johnson from Shattern State. Here we go. Whoa. Pretty rank horse right there. Be a no score for Dean Schroeder, actually. See who we got next once we clear this horse out. Our next Bronc rider will be Gillette College Cowboy Zane Howe. Speaking of Gillette, if you are driving through, make sure you stop by Govan Feed. They have everything you need for livestock, tack, ropes, 4-H, rodeo, whatever you need there. Govan Feed and Supply. Gillette, Wyoming. Give a shout out to G&L Concrete. Lisa Young, right here in Torrington, Wyoming, for all your concrete needs. G&L Concrete. There goes Zane. Oh. That is a rank one. Banner Health Community Hospital. No referral, no problem. No more sitting on the sidelines. Outpatient therapy services, no referral needed. Banner Health Community Hospital. So we get set for our next saddle bronc rider. We're running 13 of these tonight. I want to thank 21st Century and Equipment, making farming easier. Just out east on Highway 26, Torrington, Wyoming, 21st Century Equipment. Here we go, shoot five. Pretty sure this is Seth Johnson from Shattern State College. Whoa. No. That'll be a no score. We would like to thank North Platte Physical Therapy. Marty Herring and the whole crew down there do outstanding work. 1301 East M Street, right here in Torrington, Wyoming. NorthPlattePT.com. Done bronc riding?
We're probably talking about that wrong bronc.
You take over anyway.
Yeah. Oh, I'll do here, Dad. I'll do tie down, and then I'll do those two. I'll let you do breakaway, and I'll do those two.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I told you that we have a presentation that we would like to make. So at this time, we welcome the Clark family into the arena. Let me introduce them to you first from left to right. Kyler down there on the end, Kadra, the daughter, Karen, the wife, and former Eastern Wyoming College rodeo coach, Jake Clark, to my left. Let me give you just a little bit of information here. After 25 years at the helm of the Eastern Wyoming College Rodeo Team, Coach Jake Clark decided to make a change. He decided to retire from coaching and return to the classroom, where he is now teaching science and math at Eastern Wyoming College. Jake is an icon at EWC and throughout the Central Rocky Mountain region. The tremendous job that he has done with this rodeo program is unmatched. The vast number of rodeo student athletes that he has coached, mentored, and influenced are indeed fortunate individuals. During Jake's tenure here at EWC as the head rodeo coach, he coached 112 college national finals rodeo qualifiers, hosted the Rodeo of the Year 9 different times, and won several different Coach of the Year awards. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join me in congratulating former EWC Rodeo coach Jake Clark and his family, and offering congratulations for all that they've done for Eastern Wyoming College. I have plans to do an interview right there, but I think Jake would have probably slapped me with the microphone if I had given it to him. Jake is not a guy that did that for accolades. I know that he will appreciate that coat, but he also enjoyed more than anything the time that he spent working with the athletes and the kids that he mentored over those 25 years. So another big thank you to Jake Clark.
Where's that black pin, Dad?
We see the sign from the
Where's that black pin at? Where's that black pin at?
Rod Adams Farms tie-down cap rubber.
Hey. Welcome back. Goshen County Fairgrounds, Torrington, Wyoming. Seth Glass and Eastern Wyoming College Lancers home rodeo. He's got a good one started. Big flank, good little black calf laying there for him. Seth will finish out a good run. And unfortunate luck for Seth. 11 and 5 plus 10. He's going to get the penalty for breaking the barrier. Going to call Mayfield. Followed by Braden Brost. And Trace Travnicek, third out. A Wyoming-grown cowboy, Carl Mayfield, rides for the Central Wyoming College Rustlers. His calf stepped left pretty hard. He did a good job getting over there. And Carl's going to finish out a strong run. And great hustle from Carl, 11-9. Move him into the top five, a split for the top five. Braden Brost. About 30 minutes ago, we saw him move to the lead in the team roping. Rides for Casper College. A great hand here from Casper College. He's got a hard runner, and this loop's not going to work. It's going to be no time for Braden. Let's go to Trace Travnicek, an Eastern Wyoming College Lancer. Thanks to Rod Adams Farms for sponsoring our calf roping and allowing us to run this Lancer Rodeo that we love so much here in Torrington. Roan Burrows and Sam DeMille will follow. And here goes Trace. He'll chase after one. And Trace will get one wrapped up at the bottom end. So Trace had a barrier as well. 17-3 goes to a 27-3. Roan Burrows from Sheridan College. And we're halfway through our calf roping tonight. Not much leaderboard changes. In our Slack this morning, we saw Rio Nutter be a 9-2 to take an early lead. Got a pair of 11-5s, Bodie Mattson and Jake Chosick tied for second place. Carl Mayfield was an 11-9 earlier tonight. That's the fastest run we've seen so far tonight. That's splitting sixth right now. Four calf ropers remain. Roan Burrows, Sam DeMille, Tanner Whittem, Coy Thar. Little horse problems in the box here for Roan. And we're out and after one. Roan Burrows getting one set up in the middle of the pin. And he'll get one tied down. Decent finish for Roan Burrows. Shane's good. 12-2 for Roan. Second fastest run we've seen tonight. That'll be in the top 10 so far. Got a lot of ropers to sweat out, though. Thanks to Stainless and Blue Incorporated, Gary, Nebraska, for sponsoring Lancer Rodeo. Thanks to RNC Welding and Fabrication for their support of Lancer Rodeo as well. Let's go to Sam DeMille, Central Wyoming College Cowboy. Decent calf rubbing tonight. A couple barriers. A couple of smooth runs, and it'll be our second no time we've seen tonight for Sam. Big thanks to Platte River Family Dentistry here in Torrington, Wyoming, for supporting Lancer Rodeo. And thanks to Mid-States Tire. You get any flat tires on the rodeo trail, make sure to check them out. They are always helpful. Thanks to DDI Inc., Nick Goodman, Manila, Utah, for supporting Lancer Rodeo all the way here at Torrington, Wyoming. Thanks to Scott Steele and Steele's Roofing Construction. Let's go to Shadron State College. Tanner Whittem. Our second to last Cowboy to go. Coy Thar will wrap up the tie down roping. And here comes Tanner. He catches this white calf. Saw a horse a little bit fresh, but he'll still get one out there. Big lift from Tanner. And he'll finish a run. Twelve flat for Tanner. We're going to the top 10 as is right now. He'll have to sweat out a lot of calf ropers. Let's go to Coy Thar, Eastern Wyoming College Lancer. Cowboy from the state of Wyoming, former state champion high school calf roper. Riding for the Lancers, our hometown team. Coy backs his bay horse in the box. He's ready to go. Hard-running black calf. Gets him caught. Coy's got a good one set up. Big lift from Coy. And a great finish from our Lancer, Coy Thar. We will see if this calf stays tied. And it's going to be a no time for Coy Thar. Looks like he touched his calf getting up. So would have moved him into the top five, but it's going to be a no time for Coy Thar. So thanks to Rod Adams Farms for bringing us this calf roping. Rio Nutter still holds first place with a 9-2. We'll move on to our break. We're roping.
All right, we'll be going with the breakaway roping here shortly. We ran 44 breakaway ropers of slack this afternoon. Times in the top 10 go from 3-9 to 2-9. So you need to score good and get it on them if you want to make that short round on Sunday. First place right now is Tatum Runner from the University of Wyoming with a 2.9. We're going to start off with Rain Grant going to school at Laramie County Community College. Rain comes out of Wheatland, Wyoming. Gets a start on one, gets him caught. Next up will be Carissa Rahill right here from Eastern Wyoming College. I'd like to thank First State Bank out of North Platte, Nebraska. FirstStateBank.com. Also, Colorado Animal Health, Longmont, Colorado. We supply your equine needs. Colorado Animal Health. Here goes Carissa backing in the box. Looks like a good start. Sticks it on him. Calf was pretty slow. .4 for Carissa. Good start. Calf just took a little bit of time to break the rope off the horn there. It'll be a 3.4. That'll put her right in the mix. Next up is Riley Hasenek from Colorado State University. Following her will be Sierra Lee, then Caitlin Eidler. Salon Sierra, Family Salon, Encampment, Wyoming. Here we go. Our CSU cowgirl gets it around his neck, but it's going to be a little deep. Looks like we got a leg in there. Be a no time for Riley. Also like to thank Western Material Handling, abetterforklift.com, Audra McKenzie, aftermarket sales manager. Next roper is Sierra Lee out of Chatham State College, followed by Caitlin Eidler, Chantel Cobb. Sierra reaches out, just misses him. No time. Caitlin Eidler is your next roper out of Eastern Wyoming College, followed by Chantel Cobb. Here's another answer for you to get behind. Well, I'm getting hungry just looking at this ad. Rusty Tavern Bar and Grill. Weekly lunch specials, Monday through Friday, right across the border in Morrill, Nebraska. Rusty Tavern. Caitlin Eidler backing in the box. Draws a runner, reaches out, and gets him. Great loop at the bottom end. .5 for Caitlin. Next up will be Chantel Cobb, Camry Elshier, and we'll follow that with Camry Notwell. Grow Business Solutions. Kelly Groney, Marketing Materials Promotional Products. I know personally the great work that this company does. Give Kelly a call at 532-5135. GrowBusinessSolutions.com. All right, quick toss there by Chantel, but going to come up empty. Camry Elshier out of Sheridan College is your next breakaway roper.
Must be gorgeous mass.
All right, Camry's getting set. Going to come up with an oat time here for Camry. We'll finish out the breakaway roping with Camry Notrell from Eastern Wyoming College. I'd like to thank Century Lumber right here in Torrington, your farm and ranch supply center. You got stock tanks, panels, gates, hydrants, and all the wood you need. Century Lumber Center, Torrington, Wyoming. Vaughn Trailer Works, sales and repair for all your trailer needs, right down the road in Lingle. Sometimes it's tough to find somebody to fix that trailer up, but Hanson will do it. VaughnTrailerWorks.com. Camry's looking to get set. Going to come up empty. Tough luck there for the Lancer. Be in no time. So tonight we had a 3-4 by Carissa Ray. He'll be the fastest time. That will put her right in the middle of the pack. We still got that 2.9 by Tatum Runner from University of Wyoming in the lead. We'll get the barrels set up, get ready to go.
We'll have a quick rake and then be right back with us here at the Goshen County Fairgrounds, Torrington, Wyoming. Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Rodeo 2023. We got some barrel racing and some bull riding coming up for you right after this.
Is he supposed to rake anything? He's not supposed to rake anything. Contact Emily at the Ram Rodeo office. Hello. 641-684-6000.
Ram Rodeo, proud sponsor of the National Intercollegiate Rodeo Association. Cactus Ropes. Founded in 1991, manufactured ropes that are most durable and consistent products available. They can be found at local retailers, or you can reach them at www.cactusropes.com. Give them a call at 1-800-SMITH-WIN.
Yep, you can just sit up here and talk into a mic.
Oh, you're worried, right?
The NIRA also sponsored by Cactus Gear. Excuse me, Cactus Salary. Values and ethics are more than words. They are business philosophies. Cactus Salary offers a full line of salaries,
strap pins designed and manufactured by their hand craftsmen. Visit them at www.cactusassembly.com. And also visit Cactus Gear, which has been manufacturing the best equine sports products available for over 20 years.
Hey, nice. Yeah, it is. All right, let me see if I can see my paper. That might be kind of nice for a little bit.
Oh, that is kind of nice. Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be nice.
So we get our barrel pattern set up for the first barrel racing action of Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Rodeo 2023. Shout out to Brown Company, sponsor of our entry gate. Shout out to G&L Concrete, sponsor of our barrel racing. Takes a lot of people to make a rodeo like this work. Appreciate all of you watching. Appreciate all the fans. Show up to support Lancer Rodeo here in Torrington tonight. Good crowd. Taylor Johnson of Lamar will be the first to go. Hannah Huffman, a Lancer, next out. Rihanna Day, third out. Madison Keith, Emmy Norsworthy are your first five. So Taylor Johnson will be running through the Brown Company entry gate. Takes a little trouble for these barrel horses sometimes. And she makes her way through. This is our first barrel racing run of the rodeo. Don't worry, barrel racing fans. We've got 58 of them tomorrow morning. Make sure to tune in with us. YouTube, Facebook Live, wherever you want to watch. Yeah, it'll be a 16-9 plus 5 for Taylor. Hannah Huffman. Eastern Wyoming College cowgirl. And here comes Hannah Huffman. Round one. Round two. And bringing it home. Rihanna Day, 17-8 for Hannah Huffman. Rihanna Day will be next. Madison Keith will follow Rihanna Day. Amy Northworthy, third out. Got eight barrel racers for you tonight. Here comes Rihanna Day, her Palomino horse. Quick start. Going to take a quick lead in the barrel racing. Oh, and she's going to hit the third barrel. Would have been a great run from Rihanna Day, 15-4. 15-4 becomes a 24. 20.4, I mean. And that'll knock her out of contention. Madison Keith of Casper College next up. Amy Northworthy of UW next. Isabella Cogdill. Third out. Casper College cowgirl comes around the left barrel first. Kicks her way through it. Thanks to Ty's pit stop, Lingle, Wyoming, great convenience store. Make sure to stop there on your way out of town. Ed's Body Shop, Buffalo, Wyoming. Thank you for the support of Lancer Rodeo. -18 and 5 for Madison Keith. Let's go to Emmy Northworthy. University of Wyoming cowgirl. Four barrel racers to go. This is Emmy Northworthy. And here's a good run started. She's going to knock that first barrel down. Spoke too soon. Quick run. Wow. 15 and 2. Unfortunately, plus 5 is going to be a 20 and 2. Would have been far and away in first place. We'll go to Isabella Cogdale. Northeastern Junior College. Nope. We're going to go to University of Wyoming. Looks like Alex Bolton. Good run started here. And Alex will come around in the third barrel with a clean run of 16.38. Goes to first place. After seven barrel racers. Let's go to Carissa Rahill. An Eastern Wyoming College legend. Multiple time CNFR qualifier. Let's see what she can do. And another clean run. Carissa on her way home. Wow, good run from Carissa Rahill. 15.53. That'll go to the lead to end our barrel racing. Presented by G&L Concrete. So after eight barrel racers, Carissa Rahill takes the lead with a 15.53. Thanks to our Intrigate sponsor, Brown Company. We'll move on to the bull riding next. Make sure to stick with us. Goshen County Fairgrounds here at Torrington, Wyoming. Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Rodeo 2023. Looks like we have some re-rides set for the bronc riding, so stick around with us through that and the bull riding.
Okay, who do we got?
like too dark for us.
I'm just kidding. Mark a score for me.
You work the back of the Midwest AgriPro pickup in.
UWQ.
Into the arena, Brayden Huxtable and Brennicky.
Zane Brackett?
Did you mark any new rides?
Watch shoot number
he's
three.
Right here. Zane Brackett.
This is Zane Brackett.
So Zane Brackett coming out of shoot number three. Gonna fall off his horse. Be a no score for Zane. Came out of that 21st century equipment shoot. And horse was just a little too much. We're gonna go to shoot number two. Colton Broderson, Motero College. Coming out of the RNC Welding Fabrication Trucking and Crane Shoot. Thanks to Torrington Livestock, right across the road from us here at the Goshen County Fairgrounds, for supporting Lancer Rodeo. Thanks to Shock's Boot Repair. Coming out of the RNC Welding Shoot, and Colton Broderson is going to fall off quickly. So, this theme we've seen in the saddle brawl, the complete polar opposite of our bareback riding where we saw everyone ride. All seven of them. And we've just seen two qualified rides in the saddle brawl riding tonight. Still plenty of rough stock left to watch. We got some more bull riding tonight and some more rough stock tomorrow night in our perf 6 p.m. again. Get out here to the fairgrounds or tune in on YouTube or Facebook Live, wherever you're watching right now. Looks like we'll turn out our final saddle brawl course and we will move on to some bull riding. Most exciting event in rodeo for many. Final event of our evening. If you're still with us, thank you. We appreciate you all for watching. Let's ride some bulls. Seven of them. Griffin Coaster. LCCC shoot number four. That's the Dinklage Feed Yard shoot. That's where we'll be going.
Judas Food Stood. When you have a chance to patronize those businesses, we appreciate you doing so.
Who is that?
And tough scene for Griffin Coaster. We'll try to get our bowl out of the TDS collection outgate. Yeah, this is our problem with the bull riding. Can take many minutes to get our bulls out of the outgate here. Our Midwest AgriPro pickup men are working very hard to get this Southwick bull out of the arena. Oh, we had some traction there.
A little bit of denial there.
Got him. Great work by our pickup men. And it looks like we're going to be back in shoot. Shoot number five. Emmett Ross, University of Wyoming Cowboy. Six bull riders remain in our perf tonight. Nine a.m. slack tomorrow, bright and early. I think we'll get this bull riding done early enough. We'll get a good night's sleep, get ready to watch our performance tomorrow morning. And Emmett will buck off pretty quickly here. Pair of no scores to open our bull riding. Let's go to Dylan Grant, University of Wyoming Cowboy. After we get our Brindle Bowl out, of course. As all you rodeo fans know, bulls love to take victory laps around arenas. Many times we see turnback fence set up. Not here in Eastern Wyoming, you use the whole arena. And some momentum from our Midwest AgriPro pickup men. Oh, and the bull says no. About a half a second before going through the outgate. Great work by our pickup men again. And we are set to continue. Let's go to Dylan Grant, shoot number four. Dinklage feed yard shoot. So our third bull ride. Will we get our first score of the night? See what Dylan Grant can do for us.
Grant.
Nods his head. We're out and after one. Oh, wow. Thankful to see Dylan Grant get away from that one. Bull rolled over right over the top of him. Great job by our bullfighters. They're getting that bull in that out gate immediately. So again, very thankful Dylan Grant could get away from that one. So three up and three remain up. Three no scores. For our bull riders in the Central Rocky Mountain region to start it off. Let's go to shoot number three. 21st Century Equipment. Daniel Rasmussen, Sheridan College Cowboy. Always some great rough stock riders from Sheridan College. We'll see if Daniel can cover our first bowl of the 2023 Eastern Wyoming College Lancer Rodeo. Good one started from Daniel. Rode him for a couple jumps. And the Southwick Bowl will be too much for our cowboy. Had a good start for a couple seconds. Unfortunately, it is a long 8 seconds on these hard bucking bowls for our collegiate athletes to stick with them. Very fun to watch these strong bucking bulls. Making a parade lap, letting everyone know he's here, letting the judges know, letting the bullfighters know, letting the cowboys know. And we got him through the out gate. Great work by our bullfighters. Looks like let's go to shoot number two. RNC Welding Fabrication Trucking and Crane Shoot. Just a pair of cowboys left to ride. Tipton Wilson. Sheridan College Cowboy. Next to go. Here we go. Tipton Wilson's got a good one started here, and he's going to fall off. Very good go from Tipton Wilson. Rode him for about 4 seconds. But 4 seconds, just short of our 8-second whistle. So five no scores to start our bull riding. And two bowls left. Looks to me like we're going to go back to shoot number two. Wyatt Phelps. Tanner Drewke will be our last bull rider to go and shoot number three right after this.
invite you back out to be with us for performance number two. Sunday at 11 o'clock, we will...
Well, thanks for still sticking with us through the night. It's been a smooth Perth here tonight. Make sure to tune in with us again tomorrow, 9 a.m. If you're a barrel racing fan, boy, do we have some barrel racing for you. Following the barrel racing will be some calf roping, some goat tie. Excuse me, Nona goat tie. Some calf roping, some team roping. Some breakaway roping. A little bit of everything for you tomorrow morning. And another Perth tomorrow night at 6. Some more rough stock. And another buck off. One to go. Ooh. Our bullfighter gets flipped a little bit there. He seems to be up and okay. Thanks to our ambulance sponsor, Wellness Clinic here in Goshen County. We hope and pray that we don't have to use them. Incredible effort from our bullfighters putting their health on the line to protect our young bull riders. One to go, Tanner Drewke. Laramie County Community College. One more to go. We appreciate all of you that have stuck with us through the late night. And our last opportunity for Road Bull. Give me a no score. 7-up, 7-down. 7 no scores for our bull riders tonight. That'll be it for our first performance of the 2023 Lancer Rodeo. Thank you to everyone that came out and supported here in Torrington. Everyone that watched us on YouTube or Facebook Live. Be sure to tune in tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. Watch and listen with us.